I'm Cameron Champ, and you're watching Breaking Par.
Hi, it's Paige Branick.
I'm Paul Bissonnette.
Hi there, I'm Tyson Nash.
Hi, I'm Noda Begay.
Hi, I'm Shane Bacon.
Marchie Bradley.
I'm Bradle Chamblee.
I'm Ricky Fowler.
I'm Justin Thomas.
Hi, I'm professional golfer Blair O'Neill, and you're watching
Breaking Par.
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 And you're watching Breaking Par.
It's Breaking Par!
Hi, I'm Shane Doan, and you're watching Breaking Par.
She may not be a household name yet, but give it time. Her resume already speaks for itself. She's a world champion, and she's only 7 years old. Meet Beau Ellington. She's from Paradise Valley, Arizona. She's only played competitive golf for a little over a year. And recently in Pinehurst, North Carolina, she took on 47 girls from around the world.
Did you think you could win?
Yes.
And that she did, becoming one of just three girls in Arizona history to win a U.S. Kids World Golf Championship. The other two? Well, one was Tiger Woods' niece, Cheyenne Woods.
Hi, Tiger.
And the other, her best friend, Gracie.
We are best friends like sisters, and we love to go out on the golf course almost every single day and practice together and pretty much do everything together.
We call it the sister act. They are literally, they're not blood sisters, but they consider each other as sisters.
Gracie's dad, Sean, coaches and caddies for both girls, guiding Gracie and Beau to both world championships.
Beau's kind of a real flatliner. Like sometimes we get to the first tee and it's almost like she's still asleep a little bit. So we got to kind of pep her up and talk her up a little bit, but she doesn't get too high, too low. Other kids we play against, they've broke down crying. She could make a 10 or make a birdie and you wouldn't know the difference.
She handles it great. She just, nothing phases her. She smiles, she skips. You know, Sean and Beau, they'll hold hands, they'll sing songs in between. I mean, they have a blast.
But Beau admits there is one thing that gets under her skin.
The only thing that really makes me mad are three putts.
Can't fault her for that. But her even-keel mindset isn't the only strength to Beau's game. At 4'4" tall and maybe 60 pounds soaking wet, you wouldn't think she'd be long off the tee, but you'd be wrong.
She doesn't look that strong, but she is when she drives it, and she doesn't eat a lot of meat and like protein.
We tease her all the time. We call her butter noodles because all she seems to ever eat is butter noodles. I go, how do you hit it so far?
Lots of carbs.
She's way longer off the tee than these girls. Probably 30 to 50 yards on average. She's hit a couple up to 180 for a 7-year-old girl. That's phenomenal.
You think you're impressed? Imagine her second grade classmates when Beau brings in a world championship trophy for show and tell.
Are you sort of a celebrity?
Kinda. They think I'm kind of a big deal.
And when she's not crushing 180-yard drives and winning world titles?
I mean, she's just your normal 7-year-old kid that likes the weird things and making slime, like all the kids make slime now. And you take this glue and potion and food coloring and you mix it and it's really messy and most parents probably cringe when doing it.
But when it's not slime time, you'll likely find little Beau Ellington on the golf course, working, laughing, loving the game that's already made her a champion.
Are you gonna win any more world championships, you think?
I think I might win another world championship or four. I just love golf and I wanna see where the game takes me.
Coming up. Let's go learn about overseeding. Overseeding happens every year, around October, November for some.
The Bermuda base, it needs anywhere from 80 and above. So if we didn't overseed, you would be playing on grass that's browner than this. By going through the overseeding process, we'll have a green golf facility, a great playing facility year round.
This is arguably the most important 4 weeks of our entire year.
That's straight ahead on Breaking Par.
Oh, the dreaded cart path only signs. It's that time of year again, golfers. We battle to find courses that are open, and when we do, we're stuck on the cart path. But before we start complaining and pouting like the spoiled golfers we are, it's only fair that we understand why we're faced with this reality once a year. We're stuck on the paths because our golf courses have just gone through the most epic transformation known to nature, overseed.
Hi, I'm Brady Wilson. I'm the general manager here at Auction Southern Dunes Golf Club, and let's go learn about overseeding. Overseeding happens every year, around October, November for some.
In regions like Arizona, we play golf on two types of grass depending on what time of year it is. Bermuda grass in the warmer months, rye grass in the cooler months. Golfers want pristine, green golf courses all year long, so courses have to swap out the type of grass they grow in order to keep us happy.
The Bermuda base, it needs anywhere from 80 and above. The problem is when the nighttime lows start dropping in the 40s and whatnot, then it starts shutting down, and essentially it'll go dormant with the temperatures that we have in the wintertime. So if we didn't overseed, you would be playing on grass that's browner than this. We'll put perennial rye down. Perennial rye, it's a cool season grass. It thrives in our winters with our temperatures, but it also loves the 60 degree days.
That rye sits on top of the Bermuda, and you play on top of that into April and May.
By going through the overseeding process, we'll have a green golf facility, a great playing facility year round.
This is arguably the most important 4 weeks of our entire year.
These guys love this time of year. This is what they practice and prepare for. It's game on for superintendents all across the state. It's their time to shine, but the pressure's on. If they screw it up, it affects the playing conditions for the entire rest of the golf season.
I live for this time of the year. The first step that we'll do is we'll quit trying to promote the growth of the Bermuda, and we'll stop that 2 months prior to this event. Then we'll spray growth regulator, which will suppress the Bermuda. Over my shoulder is Wes. Wes is on our 300 gallon sprayer that's gonna go out and spray the growth regulator to suppress the Bermuda from actively growing, so then there's no competition when we do put down the ryegrass. As soon as our facility closes, we're gonna have all our mowers out and we're scalping. Scalping is dropping the mowers to a lower height where you're cutting it down almost to the crown of the plant, almost to the base of the plant. That's how we really open up the canopy so the seed has a good bed to lay in. As soon as we're done scalping all of the grass, then we are ready to essentially put seed down on the golf course.
Inside just a 4-day window, the Southern Dunes crew will drop 65,250 pounds of seed over 90 acres. And it's not just like they go out and throw seed everywhere. They have to be meticulous. If you double cover a section of ground with seed, it'll grow thicker in that area and look like a misspelled Scrabble board. Dropping seed is an art form because you can't see where the seed has been dropped with the naked eye.
And that's why we paint the lines so that the spread is even.
Behind each tractor, we have a guy painting for where they're throwing. So once the guy makes a pass, he's gonna turn back around. So he needs to know where he's thrown to. We all move in unison with each other when we're seeding, and that kind of ensures that we get optimum coverage of the seed. And as soon as we start laying the seed down, then it's water. From the first time that we actually see our first leaf tissue to the first time that the golfers can play on it, we wanna strive for at least 15 days.
I always just encourage golfers, give us 6 weeks and you're gonna be really pleased with the product when you get there.
From the before to the after, out here at True North on the Pinnacle Course with Mike Friend, you're gonna show us a little bit about how you guys are growing and strong here.
So yeah, a few more days left, but as you can see, the beautiful green striping, that ryegrass is coming in really nice. Let's go check it out.
Getting out here on the fairway, you can really see this rye coming in.
You know, if you take a look here closely, you can really see the difference between the two types of grass. The ryegrass is just a really thinner, taller blade, stands up nice and tall. In the Bermuda, just thicker blades, and you can see the base there.
I mean, really seeing this grass up close, you can tell why it's still pretty fragile this time of year.
You're exactly right, Ryan, which is why we have a cart path only restriction there when we open from overseeding.
It was cool to get a hands-on view of the new ryegrass coming in. Have you ever seen a golf course with no divots on it? We couldn't resist. Keep in mind that any course that's fresh out of overseed will have softer than normal playing conditions. Might want to try to pick the ball a little cleaner than you normally do. It's not hard to understand why cart path only is so important this time of year, but regardless if it makes sense to you or not, you have to deal with it. Here are a few tips to keep in mind so you don't miss a beat. First of all, Brady says it's a good excuse for grabbing a pull cart and walking the course.
You know, cart path only during the month of November, it's a great opportunity to get out and be more active and just walk the golf course.
The biggest things to remedy are yardages, pace, and club selection for shots you can't drive to in the fairway. Always bring a few extra clubs, bring a rangefinder, and always remember to bring along the sand and seed bottle. To keep a good pace of play, you and your cart buddy need to work as a team. When the first guy gets out and heads to his ball, the other guy should be advancing the golf cart further down the path. Just remember to always keep things moving. Oh, and one of the most annoying things for golf course superintendents is when golfers don't keep all four tires on the cart path. This time of year, they end up using more seed around the cart paths than any other place on the golf course.
When you come out here in November, it's pretty deceiving because when you take a look down in the soil, that's what determines how strong the plant can be.
I think all of us in the industry would hope that after you watch this piece, that everyone has a little bit more appreciation for what our guys do and respect for the golf course. And if that means you're consciously keeping all four wheels on the path during cart path only, boy, we sure would appreciate it.
Perfect. And then we're done. Thank you.
Oh, sweet.
Coming up.
On today's Cart Convo, we're joined by the captain, Shane Doan.
I've noticed so many hockey players love golf. When you see guys like Antonio Brown are seemingly all about themselves, what's your reaction to that? Most overrated fast food joint, Canada or America?
Oh.
How does someone not have a single enemy?
Oh, I got rid of all of them.
Burn. And then keep them turning, keep them turning.
That's straight ahead on Breaking Par.
Bang, bang.
On today's Cart Convo, we're joined by the captain, Shane Doan. After 21 seasons in the NHL, all with the same franchise, Doan officially hung up the skates in 2017. He retired with just about every major Arizona Coyotes club record, including points, assists, and goals. He also won two gold medals with Team Canada at the World Championships. An incredible hockey player and an even better guy. We're riding with the great Shane Doan on today's Breaking Par Cart Convo.
Doaner, thanks so much for taking the time, man.
Thank you so much for having me. Really appreciate it.
We got a beautiful day, didn't we?
It is amazing.
I've noticed so many hockey players love golf. Why is that? I mean, they're so different.
You know what? I think it's the contrast and the mental side, hockey being such a reactionary sport and golf being such a mental sport where everything seems controlled.
Now your boy is a hockey player, right?
He is. My oldest boy plays the game and loves it and can't get enough of it. He committed to ASU this summer. You guys
Sparks
are
ever, up,
there
baby.
We go.
Now last February, the Arizona Coyotes retired your jersey. The 19 is in the rafters. How emotional was that night?
It was overboard. They cheated. They used my daughter against me.
They wanted to see tears.
They did. And they got a little bit
Gentlemen,
there.
You know him as the captain. I know him as dad, Shane Doan.
I've seen a number of players retire over the years. I have never seen an outpouring of love like that on social media. Fans, teammates, folks you met once at a coffee shop. How does someone, especially in this day and age, not have a single enemy? How does a guy do that?
Oh, I got rid of all of them.
When you see guys like Antonio Brown, or there's a number of them that are seemingly all about themselves and the attention, what's your reaction to that?
Oh, you feel for them. I do. I really feel for them because everybody wants to be respected. Some people try to demand it. Some people think they can earn it. And I think the only way you can get it is by giving it away. And And that's one of those things with you see athletes that get themselves into trouble. Usually they're trying to find a way to get respect.
Ready for the speed round?
Yes, I am. I can't wait.
Ready for this?
I can't wait.
Most overrated fast food joint?
I'm not a big Whataburger fan.
Yeah. I totally could. Tell me you're In-N-Out.
I am an In-N-Out fan.
Boy. There we go. I knew it. How are you dressing your hot dog?
Oh, mustard, ketchup, and relish, because I'm Canadian. You have to have relish.
You catch a spider in the house.
Yeah.
You squashing it or a catch and release?
Oh, I'm probably squashing it.
Good man. Depends. Evil creatures.
Yes.
Evil.
Depends on the size.
Cake or pie?
Oh, cake.
Canada or America?
Oh.
I'm not going to do that
can't
to you.
Do that.
We don't broadcast in Canada, so you can just say America. What's one movie you've seen 1,000 times, but every time it's on TV, you still have to watch?
Tombstone.
Really?
I love Tombstone.
If there was a movie made about your life,
yes.
Who would play Shane Doan?
Oh, I don't know. I get teased about Keanu Reeves. I don't. Maybe it's the monotone voice.
Can you imagine Keanu Reeves playing Shane Doan?
No. Or Shrek. I've been told it might be Shrek. And I'm like, but that's a cartoon. But they're like, yeah, but that's probably who it would be more
just
like.
Just me. I'd go with a younger Robert Redford.
Oh, there we go. You know? Yes, yes.
Well, I don't know how to tally those points, but you're a winner.
Oh, thank
always
you so
a winner
much.
In my book.
I appreciate it.
Thanks for taking the time.
Hey, my pleasure. This has been great.
I gotta ask you to do me a favor, man. Ryan, he's always wanted to learn how to throw the gloves off. Can you teach him?
Yeah, I'd love to show you.
Yeah, let's do it.
Proper way to drop gloves.
You can take them off like you're pretty cool. Like drop them. Oh, like that's okay. That's all right. Huh? All right, exactly. That scares me. Then you do the full panic. The full panic is like, it's like, okay. Yeah, you can get everything up. There's a full panic is usually the way that I would end up dropping it. And then the guys that are really good, they'll give the toss at a little bit for a second.
Money.
The key really is just the wrist. So it's just the drop and then everything's back up.
So there you go, hey, there you go.
Punch me in the face.
You can get it so it's like that, it's down. And then you keep them turning.
Bang, bang. I'm like, oh my goodness.
Coming up.
Welcome to another edition of Gizmos and Gadgets. What's cool about the V2 is it's basically 4 or 5 training tools all in one. The straight tool, the hanger tool, the educator tool. You're gonna feel better contact and have more control of your golf shot. And you can see why they call it Gizmos.
TaylorMade, Callaway, and Ping came out wedges just recently.
Today we've got Mr. Cool Clubs himself breaking down some of the newest wedges to hit the market. That's straight ahead on Breaking Par.
Welcome to another edition of Gizmos and Gadgets. Earlier in this series, we introduced you to the Total Golf Trainer 2.0. In this kit, we have two devices, the Total Golf Trainer arm and the Total Golf Trainer hip. It claims to increase club head speed and distance. Ooh. Second device is the Total Golf Trainer arm. And on the take back, our wrist is forced to stay flat. Otherwise, so that was the 2.0. This is the TGT 3.0, AKA Beast Mode. I didn't make that up, that's the actual nickname. The TGT 3.0 comes with the arm and hip device, but also comes with the Total Golf Trainer V2. This is the newest TGT gadget. What's cool about the V2 is it's basically 4 or 5 training tools all in one. I'll give you my top 3 in a minute, but from jumbo grips all the way down to kids, the V2 fits all clubs. Simply pop it into the vent hole at the top of our grip, secure it using the 2 Velcro straps, screw in the rod, and we're ready to go. Let's start with the straight tool. The idea is to keep the rod pointed towards your target to help keep your hands forward through impact. But the V2 does something, say, an alignment stick can't. If you fail to keep your hands out front, you get immediate feedback. Don't feel bad about it. This happens to a lot of guys. On to the hanger tool. For this, we bend the rod forward, and at the halfway point, bend the rod to the side. The hanger tool allows us to work on 2 things, our wrist hinge and our lag. Very simple. Take the club back, and when your arm hits the rod, you've got your ideal hinge. Then you want to maintain contact with the rod through the downswing. If you maintain that lag and avoid throwing the club away, you're going to feel better contact and have more control of your golf shot. Finally, the educator tool. For this, we screw in the shorter rod, bend it forward, and check this out. Bump and run,
Place the rod on your lead forearm, perfect angle to let the ball roll out. Want a little more air time and less roll? Go with the neutral shaft. The rod stays in the middle. Remember the operation rule? For this one, you do not want to make contact with either forearm. It'll get you. So there you have it. Throw the V2 in with the TGT hip and arm, and you can see why they call it beast mode. If you'd like more info on the Total Golf Trainer 3.0, just head to the Gizmos and Gadgets page at breakingpar.net.
To all you equipment junkies out there, recently some new short game weapons hit the market. But let me ask you, what's more difficult, hitting a 47-yard chip shot or understanding the technology behind it? Today we've got Mr. Cool Clubs himself breaking down some of the newest wedges to hit the market.
Both TaylorMade, Callaway, and Ping came out wedges just recently, and I'll explain a little bit about the differences and what their technologies are and how they're going forward with it. There's the TaylorMade MG2 mill grind, the Callaway MD5, which is Mac Daddy 5, and the Ping Glide 3.0. So in general, what the companies are trying to do is maximize spin, and they all have different technologies trying to do the same thing. First wedge I want to talk to you about is new TaylorMade MG2, which is their mill grind version. What they're doing with technology is put a polyurethane insert in here, which does a couple things. It A, absorbs shock a little bit, but it also separates the weights a bit, so it makes it a little more forgiving. And it makes it feel better, essentially. The other thing TaylorMade's done on these is really small grooves. There's grooves within grooves. So they're trying to get the maximum amount of spin. The other thing they've done is this whole center section of the club, no coating on it at all. So it'll rust, but the rest of it won't. So understand, rust is not a bad thing. Tour players, for the most part, have played raw wedges for a long time. Rust actually creates friction, and obviously anytime you put a finish on a club, it makes it feel harder. So to not have the finish just on the face alone is not a new concept, but it's a pretty cool idea. In other words, the thing will sit in your bag and look pretty, but you'll still get all the benefits of no finish on the face. This would be good for, you know, tour players up to probably 20 handicaps if they got a decent short game. The next one we talk about, the Callaway wedge that just came out. This is the Mac Daddy 5 Jaws. Jaws stands for the micro grooves they put on between the grooves. So there's slightly tiny grooves between the grooves, trying to maximize spin. The other thing they've done here is, obviously, they've milled part of this out in the center. That's a thing to increase how forgiving the club is. If you take weight out of the center of anything, it increases MOI, which is moment of inertia, resistance to twisting. I've done this for years on my own clubs, actually. By putting more mass up here and taking it out of the center, it essentially makes it more forgiving and generally a lower penetrating ball flight and adds spin. Pretty forgiving for the most part, you know, tour players to 15, even 20 handicaps. Next wedge we're going to talk about is Ping's new Glide 3.0. Ping has always been good about making things forgiving. More of a channel cut in the back, so anytime you put a cavity in the back, it's a cavity weighted club, increases MOI, makes it more forgiving. They've done a good job there. There's obviously a weight that goes in the bottom of the thing that they can adjust head weights and swing weights really well. Ping's story on grooves is a little different. There's some slight milling on this. They also have some slight micro grooves, although not straight like some of the other ones. They've also done research on basically the finishes that go on wedges and how much the water wicks away from them to try and increase spin. Super forgiving golf club, probably a great wedge for somebody even to a 30 handicap with any kind of short game.
Honestly, any of these wedges could be your next deadly weapon, but no matter what set of wedges you choose to put in the bag, just don't forget, they're all made to be customized.
You definitely need to get fitted for wedges. It's an important thing.
Shake it down, shake it, shake it down. Shake it down, shake it, shake it down. Shake it down, shake it, shake it down. Shake it down.